Hello friends, welcome to another tutorial in the series of electronics and instrumentation. And today I'll discuss about a specific type of temperature transducer which is known as RTD, and it stands for resistance temperature detector. Now, a resistance temperature detector is a device which is used to determine the temperature by measuring the resistance of pure electric wire. Now, when I say a pure electric wire, this is the key feature of an RTD, that this is this sensor is basically not any hardware, or it does not involve any complex construction, but on the contrary, this is a simple pure metallic wire which is being used to detect the temperature of a given scenario. And when I say that we are using a pure metallic wire, then we are basically exploiting its property of exhibiting a change in resistance whenever it experiences a change in the temperature. So this wire itself, this pure metallic wire itself, is referred to as the temperature sensor. And because the temperature is being detected on the basis of the change in resistance of the pure metallic wire, we name it as the resistance temperature detector. Now this RTD is exhibiting a change in resistance, which is governed by a simple equation, and of course this equation is a relationship between resistance and temperature, which is given by this expression here. And you can see that this is RT is equal to R naught into 1 plus alpha T minus T naught plus beta T minus T naught whole square, and so on. It extends to the higher orders of T minus T naught. Now this RT here is the resistance at a specific value of temperature given by T degree Celsius. And this R naught, which is used on the right hand side of the equation, is the resistance value at a specific reference temperature, which I label as T naught degree Celsius. And these constants here, this alpha and the beta, and maybe the subsequent constants if I extend this equation, these are the resistance temperature coefficients, or in other words, the temperature coefficients of resistance. And the value of these constants depends on the type of metal that is being used for the construction of RTD. However, for small temperature ranges, we can always neglect these higher orders of temperature here, and this resistance equation simply reduces to only a linear equation where RT is equal to R naught into 1 plus alpha T minus T naught. Now this alpha here is the temperature coefficient of resistance, and if this alpha is having a positive value, it means that the temperature coefficient of resistance is positive, means the resistance would increase with the increase in temperature. Whereas if the value of alpha is negative, then it is the negative temperature coefficient, and the resistance and temperature for that particular metal would have inverse relationship. Now when we specifically talk about RTD, then the temperature coefficient of resistance is positive. So in other words, the resistance of the metal would go on increasing. The resistance R would go on increasing as the temperature value increases. So we have a direct relationship between the resistance and the temperature here for RTD. And now moving further, now this is a specific resistance temperature graph, and in this graph I have compared the characteristics for three different metals, you can see here. So I plotted the graph for, first of all, nickel here, and then for copper and platinum. Now, if you notice at the general behavior of the graph or the characteristics between the ratio of RT by R naught to the temperature, you can notice that this nickel is exhibiting a linear relationship. However, it shows a bump over here at a temperature range between 200 degrees Celsius to 400 degrees Celsius, and copper is also exhibiting more or less linear relationship, but again it is a bit parabolic here over and above the temperature range of 400 degrees Celsius. Whereas if we look at the platinum, it shows a very beautiful clean linear relationship between resistance and temperature. So this platinum becomes the obvious choice for the fabrication of a resistance temperature detector. And if you also notice the temperature range, it is quite wide. So this platinum, when used for the fabrication of RTD, it is capable of measuring the temperature range from minus 200 degrees Celsius to as high as 600 degrees Celsius, which is also seen here from the graph. So, and over this wide range of temperature, the graph is quite linear. The graph is seen to be quite linear. After having compared these three metals, we arrive at a conclusion that platinum is the obvious choice for the fabrication of RTD. And moving further, if we look at the construction of a RTD sensor, you can see here that this is protected inside a sheath. And why? Because just now I have mentioned that this is simply a metallic wire which is made up of a pure metal, but we need to protect this metallic wire under certain coverings. Why? Because the location at which the temperature is being detected might be far away from the control room, and that distance have to be covered with the help of the connection leads, and which has to be protected with the help of insulators so that we have minimal losses. So you can see here that this wire, this zigzag wire which I have shown here, is basically a pure platinum, and this is the resistance thermometer which would exhibit a change in resistance. This arrow shows here the variable resistance, and this sensor stops here. So only this part is the RTD, and then we have all the arrangement to take the signal from the point of interest to the control room. So this is the resistance thermometer, and then we have the connecting leads. So these bold black horizontal parallel lines are the connection leads, which are safely placed with the covering of the insulator, and then we have a sheath also to protect this signal from getting deteriorated or from to avoid any losses. So this is the basically point of concern where we want to determine the temperature, and these connection leads take the whole setup or the signal to the control room or control unit. This is a two-wire configuration. Let me tell you that because the point of interest is most of the times it is quite far away from the measuring unit or the control unit, so we make use of different type of configurations or different type of arrangements or connections to avoid the losses depending upon our priority. If accuracy is not a priority in the measurement of temperature, then a simple basic two-wire configuration can be used, which is being shown here. And now, as we have understood now that RTD is basically a change in resistance with respect to temperature, now how do we measure this change in resistance? There's a very, very simple method of measuring this change in resistance, very basic method, by making use of a Wheatstone bridge. So in a Wheatstone bridge, we can always connect this RTD as one of the four resistances, and where the other three resistances are known. So we have a resistance R1 here, which is probably known resistance, and then we have this R2 here, R3 resistances here, and this fourth resistance at this place of this fourth arm of the Wheatstone bridge is a resistance which is in the form of the RTD at a remote location. And here we have the normal power supply and the measurement of voltage here. So this is a very basic two wire configuration. But now the challenge in the measurement of temperature here is the resistance of these connecting leads. Now we are only interested in the resistance of this portion where we have attached a pure metallic wire which is working as RTD or a sensor for us. We do not want the connecting leads resistance to also feature into the output. Now this two wire configuration is helpless in eliminating the resistance being contributed by the connecting leads. So if the application does not demand a high level of accuracy, then this configuration can be used up to a distance of 100 meters between the point of interest and the location where this setup, this Wheatstone bridge, is located. So if this is less than 100 meters, then we can use this basic two wire configuration. Now in some applications, yes, accuracy becomes a major concern where we cannot neglect the resistance which is being contributed by the connecting leads. So for those applications, here is the solution. So two wire configuration, we have this modification and we name it as a three wire configuration. Now what is happening here in the three wire configuration is we are basically nullifying the effect of the connecting leads by attaching a third lead here, which is exactly opposite to what the other two leads are doing. So whatever resistance is being contributed by the connecting leads, the effect is being nullified by attaching a third lead, or is also known as the compensating lead for the RTD. So all other construction and parameters remain same. And now to further increase the accuracy of RTD, we have another arrangement here, which is a four wire resistance configuration. Now this four wire resistance configuration, you can see here that we are using now this PT100, it stands for platinum 100. PT stands for platinum, and 100 means the resistance of 100 ohms at a standard temperature of 0 degrees Celsius. And of course this whole arrangement is also digitized, so we have a DVM here. DVM of course stands for digital voltmeter, and 1 milliampere constant current generator is being used here. Now if you notice the directions of the arrows here, if this movement of the current is in this direction, I denote it by plus A, then this opposite is minus A, so the effect is nullified. And of course if this is plus V, we have a minus V here, so this is only to increase the accuracy. So here you can notice that a four terminal sensing eliminates the voltage drop in the measuring leads, which is a major contribution to the error. And to increase the accuracy further, or any residual thermoelectric voltages which are generated by different wire types. Now these different wire types can also contribute to the thermoelectric voltages, and of course the screwed connections are eliminated by the reversal of the direction of the 1 milliampere current here, which I have just mentioned. So the reversal is basically nullifying the effect of any chances of error here. So that gives us the four wire configuration for RTD. And also by averaging the reverse measurements, the thermoelectric error voltages are even cancelled out. And so that is all about the RTDs, the basic construction, the wiring configurations, and the principle of working. So I hope this quick tutorial on RTD was of help in understanding. So this is a very, very basic and a very, very simple transducer or a sensor which is used, widely used for the measurement of temperature. So I hope you understood it well, and I'll see you soon in more tutorials to come. Till then, keep visiting the channel and keep sharing the videos. Have a good day. Bye bye.